If we want to build a community where people can start sharing information about what they know about certifiable software and how, what they want to do. And here we are talking about creating a community where everybody can participate to it with their own knowledge and their own tools and their own knowing. So we have tried to see what would be the various components of such an activity. Well, we have talked about life cycle management. Clearly, the DO have specific workflows. We know that traceability is the hard problem to solve. And especially if you want to make different tools communicate together in your global environment, you need traceability to be solved at the system levels, yes, but you need to do it in a way that is sufficiently open and standard so that various tools can work together in producing the traceability you need at the end. That's a difficult problem. So far, there is no standard method of doing that. Everybody does it his own way. And trying to find a way so that tools can communicate and provide the information that is needed to solve this traceability problem is extremely interesting and important. Qualified tools. If there are open qualified tools out there, they are definitely interesting OpenDO components. So I mentioned Couverture, that will be a tool that has been built from scratch to be an open tool that will come with complete qualification material. You also have open development tools. I mean, there is one person here in this room that knows about one open development tools that has been developed as part of GeneAuto and whose purpose is to generate qualified code out of Simulink models. So extremely impressive piece of work, still under development, but they're already good. There is already a good starting point here. And we can imagine even open qualification material for tools that are not open themselves. For instance, if you are using, let's say, Word for this or that, you could qualify Word for this specific DO 7.8 activity and open the qualification material so that others can benefit from them. Education material is probably the most important ones. In the context of D178C, there are a lot of new things happening, and it will take 10 years to the industry to understand what has been meant by the different authors of the supplement, as it took 10 years to understand what was in the DO originally. If we can manage to convince the people working on those supplements to produce examples, completely open examples, and the ways of working, and what they really meant when they wrote their supplements, that will be extremely valuable to the practitioners. Clearly, if we had toy projects, certificate projects, several of them using different tools and things like that, that would be of enormous value for universities and even for companies that need to go in that market and have no clue how to do that to start with. Right now, the learning process is extremely difficult and complicated. Certifiable components. I mentioned 653OS earlier, but you have many components that, if they were available as an open source with certification material, could be used by almost everybody. We have a lot of customers that would love to have a light database solution for level C, for instance. That's something that is extremely popular, but there is no... Today, you have several databases that are open source, but none that can be qualified easily. So this notion of qualifiable components is certainly of interest. You have plenty of other possible, I mean, standard classes for various languages, middleware of any kind. IP stack are typically low-level layers that people could collaborate on rather than try to have their own solution on their side. And that would not jeopardize their own business opportunities. And clearly, you have document templates or parts of document templates that could allow you to produce very quickly your coding standard, your PSAC, your SAS, and so on for DO. Having templates that allow you to do it right and in the proper way will certainly help a lot of people. So I think I will skip. OK, so I almost... at the end of my talk, so I will probably skip a few of my slides. What I wanted to say at that point is that right now, we are starting this project. OpenDAO is not a reality today. It will become a reality as soon as there are enough people contributing to it. So if anyone in that room has some ideas on how to contribute to some elements like that, or even some new elements that we didn't think of, because so far we put just what we thought about, but I'm sure you guys have some other ideas of what could be shared to help create such a community. We are extremely interested to know about it. So here I was trying to explain why it is important for industrial avionics community to participate to such an OpenDAO initiative. Clearly, in the long term, if you are looking for long-term benefits, having such an open community will work for you definitely, especially if you're able to contribute back your own changes to the community, because contributing back your own changes to the community is not for the benefit of the community only, it is for your own benefits, because otherwise you will not be able to acquire new versions of what has been developed by the community without having to reapply all your changes one by one in something that has completely changed. So the business of of providing to the community what you have done for yourself is extremely important for yourself and not for the community. It is important also for the community because they will benefit from that. Everything that you have done that makes the software better, more functionality and safer is good for everybody. But it is first and most important, it is important for you so that you can benefit from the rest of the work that has been done by the community afterwards. So the key to success for this initiative is first to find the right balance between whatever is pushed by Boeing or whatever is pushed by Airbus. It cannot be an initiative by Airbus or by Boeing. It has to be both or none. And actually, both are interested, so that's a good news. It cannot be certification authorities versus industry. I mean, we need to involve certification authorities at some point. They're also somewhat interested, even though they probably will have to stay a little bit outside because of their position. And we also have to make a balance between Europe and the US. That would be too bad that such an important initiative would be too much geographically constrained. So for us, it is important to, from the start, make sure that we have the right balance between Europe and US and the rest of the world, obviously. We need to find key participants. That's why we are talking about this initiative everywhere. So if you have something to contribute, please contact us. Our plan so far is to attract public funds for the bootstrap procedure of OpenDAO. And for that, we are already planning to work on the FP7 program, that is to say European community-funded project. We know that the call for tender will appear in 1 month, and we need the submission of the proposal in 4 months. We will, on the other side of the Atlantic, start to find what are the opportunities for funding and things like that, so that we can start a project in the US at the same time with the key players over there. And what we want to achieve is to make sure that those two projects that will bring the best of the of the industry and the academics and two providers on both sides of the Atlantic can share from the start some infrastructure, some ideas, some activities, and things like that. So that's basically the idea that we'll create a community from that will bootstrapped by different projects on which everybody could contribute wherever they are. So if you have something, if you believe you have something to contribute to this community and would like to participate to one of the projects, you have something to put on the table for instance, for the European project or the US project, for which I don't have information right now, but we'll have later. Please go to opendio.org and send a message. So far, the website is still in its early stage, but you already have at least an email address where you can send a message saying that you are interested to participate to those activities. This initiative will work if people from the industry and from the academic community participate to make it happen. So that will not be an EDACOR initiative, that will be our initiative to all the people that are interested by that approach.